Hey guys, in this video, I want to talk about skull stripping in FreeSurfer and how to troubleshoot it if the skull strip was wrong. So this is a tutorial page from the official FreeSurfer website. It goes over the two main ways on how to fix a bad skull strip. So first, before we talk about that, skull stripping is a step that's done early on in the processing stream. I don't have a little graphic to show you, but it's done within the step that's called AutoRecon 1. So it's done before any labeling or any segmentation occurs, and it's basically what removes the brain from the skull and the non-brain tissue surrounding the brain. This is an important early step because if you mess up the skull stripping, or if FreeSurfer messes it up, then it might remove part of the brain, or it might consider non-brain tissue as part of the brain. So this affects later steps, such as what it considers when it does peel reconstruction. So what is it considering the peel surface? And if it includes the dura mater, you'll get incorrect results. And then it can also affect gray and white matter segmentation, which occurs later on as well. So you can check your segmentation after a recon all is done, or you can check your skull stripping after auto recon 1 if you're not doing the all tag to run the whole processing to check if the skull stripping looks like it was done correctly or not. So sometimes you might look at a segmentation of your brain, of the gray and white matter, and see that it's wrong, but it might be wrong just in a few places, in which case you can manually correct the labeling on your own without having to fix the skull strip. But sometimes you might want to go back and fix the skull strip if you see a lot of errors, because rerunning the skull strip after it's been correcting can help avoid lots of errors later on. So in this video, I'm just going to talk how to do manual edits, which if you read this tutorial, which I don't know if I said it already, but I'll put the link in the description box below. This tutorial says that for manual edits, you want to keep that to if you just have a few edits that you want to make. It's not advised for if you have a bad skull strip with a lot of errors, in which case they'd rather you try to do watershed parameter changing first, or to try to use G-Cut, but I'll talk about those in another video. So first, let me pull up some code that I have. So for this code, and I'll put the link in the description below, I have to upload it. This goes over basically how you can look at your skull stripping. You can basically check it first, and you can do that either using FreeView or TKMedit, which is what I would use. And you can see basically if the skull stripping is correct or not. The skull stripping is going to produce, after it's done, a file called brainmask.mgz. So this is what you're looking at. So if you open it up through TKMedit, you're going to type in TKMedit and then the name of your subject folder in your FreeSurfer subjects directory, brainmask.mgz, which is the file we want to look at to see if it's correct or not. And then later on for fixing it, you might want to already go ahead and do this step, which is add the auxiliary tag. And then you're going to put in the T1.mgz, which is basically the T1 weighted image that you got as input for FreeSurfer. And it's automatically generated when you run AutoRecon 1, so it automatically creates a file called t1.mgz. That's not something you have to create yourself. And then you can put a tag called surfs, and this will show you the gray and white matter segmentation. So if I click that, oh, actually, I have to fix the subject name. So if you run that, that will open TKMedit, and it will show you the TKMedit little GUI box and also this box, which has the brainmask.mgc loaded as the main volume. And as you can see here, it has in parentheses the auxiliary volume. So depending on your computer keys, you're going to click Control 1 and Control 2 to toggle between the auxiliary and the main volume. So if you can see there, this is the T1. And as you can see, the T1 includes the skull, it includes the dura mater, and the skull stripping is the brain mask, which you hope has it removed. So that's one way of looking at your results, and then you can also do it using the FreeSurfer way. So in the FreeSurfer way, you just want to make sure you first CD into your applications folder, and then you want to run this whole code, which it has on this tutorial website. So it's basically this code, and you just input your name of the subjects folder instead of this skull strip 1 underscore before. So if I want to look at it through FreeView, I have to CD to my subjects folder first, and then I'm just going to copy this code, and that opens FreeView. And if you let it load, it will show you basically the same thing as the TKMed will show you. It'll show you the segmentation between gray and white matter. So the white matter is everything in the yellow, and the gray matter is everything in the red borders. And so you can scroll through this either through TKMed or through FreeView to see if you have any errors in your segmentation. And if you have a lot of errors, it might be better to try to fix your skull strip before you try to manually edit the gray and white matter segmentation. Pulling this up through TKMed again, I'm just going to expand this window. So I'm just going to look through a couple of the slices. I can already see that this, for example, is not brain. And if you can see here, leaving some skull is okay sometimes, but it can sometimes produce errors. So for example, this looks like an error. Here, it looks like it's picking up some non-brain skull, or that might be dura mater, and it's picking it up as gray matter. So that's a small error. The segmentation here, for example. And yeah, if you see here, it just looks like it's not accurately picking up some of the borders. The tutorial actually recommends that you look at it through the sagittal view. That's a good way of picking up errors. And especially if you look at the longitudinal fissure or near the longitudinal fissure, which is what separates the left and right hemispheres, you'll often see that there are pieces, like for example, here, it's not doing a good job getting rid of the non-brain tissue. And again, you can toggle between the brain mask and the T1 and see that all of this should have been removed, but it's not doing a good job of removing it in the brain mask, and so this is causing some errors, although it doesn't look too bad.